So hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make this CRT effect on Premiere Pro. So to break it down, there will be four layers total, starting with the original clip that's going to be on track one. The second one will be a duplicate of that original clip that's going to have blur and a different blending mode. This gives the clip a dreamy like effect, so before and after you can see it looks a little more blurry. The third one is an adjustment layer, and this one is going to have our most important effects. It's going to have grid, lens distortion, strobe light, and Gaussian blur. Also, a quick heads up, Adobe removed grid and also some other effects, I think after the 2023 update, but there is a way to get it back and the link is in the description below. Anyways, the last adjustment layer, so take a look. Alright, so right now it looks kind of plain, but once I add this adjustment layer on top, you'll see that there is a RGB split effect. This here is the cherry on top. So yeah, let's get started. So to begin, prepare your clip. If you haven't nested it already, then do so. Your clip might look like this. So what you want to do is just reframe it if necessary and scale it up. Mine's already scaled up, so don't need to do that. And what you want to do is right click, head over to nest and click OK. Then it's going to look like this. So I am going to duplicate it by holding Alt on my keyboard and click and dragging it up onto my second layer. First of all, I'm going to set the opacity down to 25% and set the blending mode to color dodge, this one right here. Search for Gaussian blur underneath blur and sharpen and add that onto the layer. And you want to set the blurriness amount to 225. All right, step one done. Now we need to make an adjustment layer. So head into your product tab, right click, new item, adjustment layer, and click OK. Place this on top of your clips, so on the third layer, and extend. So starting with the first effect, it is grid. As I said, if you don't have it, then click the link below so you can restore it back into Premiere Pro. So I'm going to add this onto my adjustment layer, change the size from to width and height sliders, set the width to 2000 and the height to 6 and the border to 7. Now I've got my scan lines, but there's this weird split in the middle. So what you can do is use the anchor to move it to the left or right. So I'm going to just drag it by using this first value. So click and drag and move it to the right. And now it's gone. Perfect. So what you want to do next is click on invert grid and change the color from white to black. Set the blending mode to hard light, this one right here. Close this effect by clicking on the arrow next to the effects button. And the next one we're going to add is lens distortion, this one underneath distort. So add that onto your adjustment layer and head back into effects controls. First of all, disable the fill alpha, and you want to increase the curvature to an amount that you like. So I think for me, 20 looks pretty good. If you want less of a curve, then pick something like 10, which is a little more subtle. I'm going to stick to 20 and close that. And I'm going to add on the blur effect once more. So this one underneath blur and sharpen onto the adjustment layer, set the blurriness to 10 and the blur dimensions to horizontal. I'll show you a before and after. So if I just zoom in, so this is what it looks like before and after. I think it looks a little more realistic. Feel free to disable it if you don't like it, but before, after, it looks nice. And the final effect is strobe light. This is for the flicker effect. First of all, change the strobe color to black and then the blend with original to 95%. Strobe duration, set that to 0.1 and the strobe period to 0.2. Add on one more adjustment layer, and this one has to be on top of the existing adjustment layer, otherwise it won't work. And for this adjustment layer, you just want to add on VR digital glitch. So add that onto the adjustment layer and head back into effect controls. The very first thing you're going to do is uncheck the auto VR properties box. Open up the distortion settings, color distortion, set this one to 20 and the distortion rate, which is this one here, all the way down to 0. Now to give it some texture, you can add some noise. So open up noise down here and set the strength to 15 or higher. That's going to make it look a little more fuzzy. So before and after. If you want more RGB split, so if I zoom in, you can see it is obvious. On some clips, it might not be that obvious, as I say, so you can increase the color distortion to a higher amount. Go for something like 50, and that's going to give you a stronger RGB split effect. If you want to go even further, what you can do is export this at a low quality. So I'm going to head to the start, press I on my keyboard, and to the end of my clip and press O, because this is the segment I want to export. So I'm going to press Ctrl M to bring up the export panel, expand the video tab, and what you want to do is uncheck this box. So for the frame size, it's going to be checked, so just uncheck it, and you want to set the height to something like, let's go for 480. And hey, you might like it, you might not, it's totally up to you. So let me go for something a little higher, maybe 720. And don't forget to set the bitrate to something absurdly low, like 1, and that's going to make it look even more realistic. You can apply this effect onto your other clips simply by duplicating the adjustment layers. So hold Alt on your keyboard, click and drag both, and extend. It's perfect, but just one more thing, we need to duplicate the original clip. So duplicate that, and we can actually copy the effects over. So if I head over to my original clip, the duplicated one, I can hold Ctrl on my keyboard, click Opacity and also the Blur, right click, copy, head over to my duplicated layer here, right click, paste. And there you go. And that's how you achieve a CRT effect on Premiere Pro with no plugins. Thank you very much for watching. Check out this video here if you are interested. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.